When I was talking to someone about me being at the Bureau, the first thing that, you know, they say straight away is, oh, playground for technology.
I'm product generation team manager.
I'm an IT project manager.
I look after the national radar network.
I'm the general manager of user centre design.
ICT change manager.
Group executive data and digital, chief information technology officer.
Currently working as a numerical prediction program manager.
Physics gives you a lot of tools about how to think about the world.
Technology is everywhere in everything that we do at the moment, so I just wanted to be involved in it and I wanted to know how it worked.
I recall when I was little, my dad got me a very small scientific calculator which can program. You can do like little basic programming in it, and I was, you know, delighted by it, and I thought, oh my god, I could do something more with this in the future.
What drew me more were some of the real practical engineering and science subjects that I could see actually bring something that's on paper and actually bring it into reality so that we can use it as a society.
I think IT is a really creative sort of role. A lot of people don't see it as that, but a lot of artistic and creative people sort of seem to flock to it.
The skills gained in this career, they are applicable in pretty much any occupation and in any industry.
In terms of STEM and what's happening in the Bureau at the moment, there's all sorts of opportunities. We're really at the forefront of how technology, from data to platforms to software development, we're across all aspects of STEM.
You're actually encouraged, you know, to try new things and, you know, test those innovations, be creative and think out of the box.
We still need to encourage our young women to consider a career in STEM.
Gender biases have certainly broken down, and, you know, it's talented women that keep pushing and never give up that actually do that.
You know, to me, if it was easy, you wouldn't do it. It's got to have that challenge about it to make it worthwhile.
I think if you think that there are barriers, that barriers can arise.
To stand up, have a voice, be heard, and just trust in your opinion.
Have the confidence to, you know, to speak your mind.
Things aren't going to be easy. You'll need courage along the way just to keep moving forward in order to achieve the things that you want to achieve.
Don't limit yourself to maybe what we do nowadays, because in 10 years' time, 20 years' time, it will change.
Don't think about the job you're doing, think about the next one up. Think about where you want to be and whether it's going to cross and what scope that gives you. Think about growth.
Don't box yourself in. Don't tell yourself that you're not good at something or you can't do something.
And make the most of what life could offer.